Hey, big board, folks, followers, friends, fans, haters, detractors, decriers. Streets of Stalingrad, L2 edition, design group edition. Fairly beefy rule book for this guy. Well laid out, though. Not too much by way of errata. In fact, there is designer notes, and on the index at the back really brings this down to about 24 pages, I think. Yeah, 24 pages of rules. It feels like a 30-page rule book, though. I mean, here's what's interesting about this game. Okay, you've got this big set of historical commentary that I will actually like to have a read of. A nice booklet full of explanations of the counters and examples of play. Look at all these different things. See, this is going to be a big game. Wow. Yeah. We've got some stuff going on here. That's taking the wind out of my sails. That's interesting. Charts. Here's what I really did want to focus in on. Let me just move this from underneath the camera. These are huge, and I'm not sure why these are so big. This is terrain modifiers and combat modifiers table. And this is the sequence of play. I mean, really? Does it need to be like this? Does it need to be this complicated? That looks complicated. Maybe it's a great big rule summary. But here's what I wanted to look at. Here are the scenarios that you can play. There's one for each side, and you put your counters out and lay them all out, and away you go. I've got the game notes and replacements, how to win, up on the right hand side here. You've got miscellaneous starting units, reinforcements, end of the game, and there's another scenario on the back, right? So you think, oh, that's pretty cool. And I think everybody knows there's 3 maps or 2.5 maps to this. And these summary setup maps that show you the areas of play. So we're going to play this grain elevator scenario. So we're playing this scenario here. And this will be representative of our exploration of the Stalingrad campaign. I don't think that I'm going to try and do the whole shoot and match. And here's why. Because no, that's not it. Where is it? Yeah. I think this is one of the campaign scenarios. Look at, I mean, this is just monstrous. There's, you know, 15 of these, 9 of those, and 4 of those, and a box of naked lady tees. I mean, there is just units and units and units, reinforcements out of the yin-yang. That's just the Soviet setup. So as you can see, this is pretty substantial. And for all that I'm very curious and interested in this particular campaign, I don't know that I would want to try and tackle this guy solo. The other challenge that I'm going to have with trying to do this solo is, here's how the game came. It's all packed and all organized pretty well. But once we learn what the counters actually mean and you know, where the unit designations are and things like that, we can get some better understanding and just see how much effort is involved in setting up. But there's a lot of stuff, huh? So this is going to be quite a big job. So we will, I'm going to start reading the rules on this guy. I'm going to pack this up, start reading the rules, and we'll kind of go at it from there. I'm going to look forward to catching up with you guys on this particular topic and Tunisia and what else? What was the other topic? Oh, and the Caucasus campaign. Later.